Paris, a new study from Northwestern Medicine found 85% of so-called long-haul COVID-19 patients faced neurologic symptoms even after recovering from the illness. The study looked at 100 long haulers who were not hospitalized for COVID and had relatively mild cases, but experienced lingering issues like fatigue, brain fog, and dizziness, symptoms that impacted their daily life and, in some cases, their cognitive abilities. Joining us are Dr. Edie Graham, a Northwestern Medicine neurologist and co-author of the study, and Eddie Palacios, a commercial real estate broker from Naperville and a Northwestern patient who participated in the study. And thank you both for joining us. Dr. Graham, first of all, just give me a brief definition. What do you mean by long hauler?
So the long haulers of COVID-19 are the patients who have symptoms that are lasting for longer than 6 weeks. So we find that most patients will recover in that amount of time. So specifically, we are seeing the ones that are having the neurologic long haul symptoms.
And as I mentioned, some of the most common symptoms the study found were brain fog, headache, numbness, and tingling, and disordered taste or smell. What is the potential impact on patients' lives, Dr. Graham?
This has the chance to really impact their ability to work and to really get out of their home at all. Many of these patients are experiencing extreme fatigue, are not being able to concentrate, are unable to carry out their usual daily activities.
And Eddie, your family all got COVID in September, your entire family, and they recovered, but your own case was fairly mild. And when did you first start noticing that maybe things weren't quite right for you?
About a month after, I started seeing things. I started forgetting things like salt or, you know, conversations I was having. It was all short-term memory that I was losing.
And besides short-term memory, any other symptoms that manifested themselves?
Yeah, every injury I ever had, I could feel, still do. I get headaches that, you know, will last days. A little foggy head as well, you know, but it's the memory loss. I was stuttering, but stuttering's gone. But it was really the memory loss and the body aches that are really, you know, intense.
You mentioned that in your career, it's so important for you to be able to communicate with potential clients and so forth. A little bit more about brain fog, because that is one of the leading symptoms. Eddie Palacios, tell us about that.
Well, you know, it's just, I've learned to adapt, but at the beginning I couldn't focus on anything. I would look at things and I'd be like, okay, I got to work on a project, and I just couldn't do it. And I have big clients. And so I had to readjust, and I have post-its everywhere. I take notes, lots more notes than I ever took. And, you know, the running joke with my clients that I was like the walking Google. Now I'm like the walking AOL, but you know, I've adapted.
Dr. Graham, is it possible that some patients have these long-term effects and may not completely realize it?
Well, I think most patients are pretty good at identifying subjectively when they do have brain fog. But the patients that we looked at, we were trying to really quantify what that meant, because of course there were a bunch of chat rooms on Slack and Facebook with a lot of patients discussing this, but we wanted to take it to a scientific journal. So we wanted to look at cognitive measures. We had patients do in our clinic cognitive testing and found that they had decreased attention and decreased working memory, our patients who were suffering from the long haul effects of COVID-19.
Eddie Palacios, you were tested. How do those tests go?
Not well. I've done them twice and didn't do too well. And, you know, the working memory was definitely failing. And, but with the help of the good doctors here, I've been getting better and better. So, yeah.
What has your treatment been like? What have they been doing to help you get better and better?
I've been put on medication, smart drugs, to help me focus. They did lots of blood work, checked everything to make sure there was nothing else going on. We found that I had sleep apnea, so they helped me with that as well. So, you know, it's just been, you know, being at the front of this whole thing, it's, you know, I feel for the doctors because they're doing everything they can and, you know, they're trying everything. And, you know, at first they, you know, the medications I was getting were for Alzheimer's and they kept switching them. And we finally found the, you know, medication that worked, and it seems to you know, I can function, I can do things. And, you know, it's, like I said, being on the front line there, these guys are working hard and trying to make things right. And it's trial and error. It really has been. And, you know, I'm lucky, but, you know, that they've had the attention they've put into this.
Eddie Palacios, let me stay with you for a minute, because I understand you're doing some other things just to help your mind sort of regain focus, get out of that fog. What kinds of things are you doing?
Well, you know, my mother's a retired hypnotherapist, and she helped me move the pain from my head to my knees, where I have injuries there. So I've done a lot of hypnotherapy, and, you know, I've grown up around hypnotherapists all my life. So between her old partner and herself, they've helped. I've done some acupuncture that seems to alleviate some of the pain. But, you know, tried hyperbolic tanks. I've tried everything. I mean, I've tried different things on my own, obviously checking in with the doctor. Hey, what do you think of this? And they go, all right, try it, but who knows? And it's been, you know, I guess in my case, I've been my own advocate, and I've really kind of pushed, you know, yes, I've got Northwestern on my side, but I'm also looking at every option, because I definitely don't like being in this place that I'm in. But, you know, I have noticed that I've gotten better and better, you know, little by little, you know, but it's an adventure every day.
Doctor, how effective are the treatments, are the strategies for helping people with these long-term effects? What kinds of things are there?
Yeah, so we don't have any clinical trials yet. It's too early to know how effective exactly these treatments are. And we don't have one specific cure-all for these patients who have long-haul symptoms, and mostly because a lot of these symptoms differ from patient to patient. So while one patient may suffer from migraines, another patient may be suffering from debilitating vertigo, and those things you're going to treat very differently. So until we know more about the root cause of why this is happening in the long COVID patients, we're going to continue to treat symptomatically. So for things like Eddie was mentioning, like for brain fog, we've used medications like amantadine and modafinil. For migraines, we've used medications like nortriptyline. For vertigo, we've used medications like meclizine and vestibular rehab. But we are also leaning on a lot of our colleagues in neuropsychology and sleep medicine, as well as rehab, pulmonary, cardiology, all of these things to really work on patients and look at them as a whole.
And that's where we'll have to leave it. Our many thanks to Dr. Edith Graham and Eddie Palacios. Mr. Palacios, good luck to you, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.